Good afternoon all. A warm welcome to Suryapet Khammam Bioscience online class. I am Kausar Anjum, working as DGT Science in TSMS Imampet Village, Suryapet Mandalay District. Children, today I am here to present you the topic crop protection, in which we will learn about weeds, insects and plant diseases. So when I finish my class, what are the learning outcomes? Once we will see this. So after my class, you can learn various means of crop protection. That means various methods. How can we protect the crop? You can give complete information on weeds, its effects on our crop, and how those weeds can be controlled. And you can identify various symptoms seen in plants caused due to the attack of insects and can suggest the controlling methods. You can give reason why we should not use chemicals to control plant diseases. And you can suggest various biological pest controlling methods. You can explain various harmful effects seen in human beings due to the use of pesticides on crops. And finally, you can analyze how insects and microorganisms are harmful to crops. So let's begin our session. Here you can see a farmer. So this farmer has used best variety of seeds in his crop and in his field, sown the seeds at correct time, applied fertilizers and irrigated the crop well at proper times. He has taken all the measures, proper measures to get the best yield. Is there any surety that he will get maximum yield, or is there any obstacle to get his crop? So is there any obstacle? We will see now. So the obstacle what he will get is he has to take proper measures for the protection of the crops. He has taken all the best variety of the seeds. He has planted the seeds at proper time. He has given water. He has provided water at the proper times, used all the fertilizers, okay, in the required amounts. Everything he has done very well. But now the major problem he is going to face, the protection of the crop. So here, how can he protect the crop? With what he should protect the crop, we will see now. Here you can find an image where you can see the crop of maize. So can you find any other plants along with these maize plants? Just observe. So what these plants growing in between the maize crop are called? So this is the maize crop growing in the rows, but in between these rows, there are some other plants are also growing, isn't it? So what these plants are called? Those are called as weeds. So to know more about weeds, we should have some questions. So to get the information, what do we need? We need a question. So here some of the questions I have framed for you to get the more information on the weeds. So what those are, what are weeds? Do you know any names of the weeds? What effects do the weeds have on our crop? And how can we control the weeds? So you have to think about all these questions. So first the question is, what are weeds? So here in this picture, in the previous slide, I have shown you the plants which are growing in between the rows of the maize crop. These plants are called as weeds. So do we have any use of these crops, which are growing in between the maize crop? This is the grass. So what is the use of crop? Do we get any food from the grass? Is it necessary that this grass must be grown in the field? Okay, these are not needed. So these won't give any food to the human beings, isn't it? So these are the unwanted plants. So what are the weeds? Weeds are the unwanted plants which grow along with our crop. Actually, we have grown the crop, this maize. So along with the maize, some of the unwanted plants have also grown. So these here, the plants shown are the grass plants. So these are the unwanted plants. All these unwanted plants are named as the weeds. I hope you have understood what are weeds. All the unwanted plants are called as weeds. Next, do you know the names of some weeds? See here, children, here some of the pictures are displayed on the screen. You might be familiar with all these plants, but you may not be known their names. So one, I will familiarize you with their names also. This is majorly the grass. This is called as Dallas grass, and this type of grass is called as a nutsedge. And this is the plant which is called as common purslane, and this is a bar clover, and this is the most favorite plant to the children with which they play. It is a dandelion, and you have come across with this dandelion word in your seventh standard, isn't it? So all these are the names of the weeds. Now there is a next question. What effects do the weeds have on the crop? Weeds will grow along with the crops, isn't it? Is there any effect on our crop if the weeds grow? Yes, definitely, because weeds compete with our crop. Okay, we will provide water, nutrients to our crop, but these weeds will take the water and also occupy the space which we are providing for our crop. And also they will take all the nutrients which should be taken by the our crop plants, but these will compete with our crop plants and will take the nutrients, occupies the space and also the water. And these weeds grow faster when compared to our crop plants. When they grow faster, what happens? These weed plants will be taller and compared to our crop plants, and the maximum sunlight will be taken by the weeds, and the shade is provided to our crop plants, because of which our crops cannot undergo photosynthesis and cannot prepare its food and cannot show the proper growth. So weeds are dangerous to our crop, which further affects the yield of the crop. And weeds also provides shelter to some of the pathogens. Pathogen means disease causing agents. The disease causing agents like bacteria, some other insects accommodate on the weeds and affect our crop. So there is lot of effect. We have very harmful effects of weeds on our crop. That is, the weeds compete with our crop for nutrients, space, water. These all the things will not be taken properly by our crop, and also weeds grow faster than our crop and take maximum sunlight, which also retards the growth of our crop. And also weeds provides a shelter to most of the pathogens, which also subjects to diseases to our crop. So weeds are very dangerous. Those must be controlled. So here, how the weeds are controlled? How can we control the weeds? So weeds are controlled by different methods. One is manually, second is mechanically, chemically, and also by biological methods. So manually, in the sense, we can pluck out those with our hands. Mechanically means we can use some tools to remove those weeds. And chemically means we have to use the chemicals. In your eighth standard, you have learned about the 2-4-D. Okay, so that is a chemical which is called as herbicide, which kills the dicot weeds, and also by the biological methods. Some of the insects feed on these plants, so we have to use the biological methods also. So here, the process of removing weeds is called as weeding. So removing of weeds is called as weeding. So weeds must be removed, otherwise our yield decreases. Next, our topic is insect and plant diseases. So what are the diseases which are caused by the insects? We will see. See here, the major problem the farmer faces after taking all the precautions is the crop protection. So with what the crop is protected must be protected is from the weeds, and it also must be protected from the insects and also from the microorganisms. So in the previous slides, we have learned about the protect, how we can protect our crop from the weeds. Now in the further slides, we will learn about how can we protect our crop from the insects and also from the microorganisms. So first, to protect the crop, we have to know, to protect the crop from insects, we have to know how the insects are harmful or dangerous to our crop. What can the insects do to our crop? Let's see that. See here, most of the insects, they will eat the stems, and some of the insects nibble at the leaves, while some of the insects destroy the roots. So what is the meaning of the nibble here? Taking of small bites of food is called as nibble. So here you can see in the picture, this is the insect which is going on eating the leaf. Can it take complete leaf at a time, or can it take a major part of the leaf at a time? No, it can take small bites, isn't it? Slowly it can go on eating the leaf. So this process of eating is called as nibbling, or it is called as nibbling. So most of the insects will eat the stems. So some of the insects nibble at the leaves, and while others, they destroy the roots. So when it goes on eating, finally the leaf turn to in this way, and it also changes its color. So this is about the this is how the insects are harmful to the plants. Now here there is a question displayed: do all the insects harm plants? Here these insects are harmful to the plants, isn't it? But are all the insects harmful to the plants? No, all the insects are not harmful. The best example for this is the honeybees. Honeybees are the most important insect which brings out the pollination. When the pollination goes on, then only the food is formed, isn't it? Then only the seeds are formed, which is the food to the all the organisms on the earth. So pollination is brought out because of, most of the pollination is done because of the honeybees, which are acting as a pollinating agents. So all the insects are not harmful. Few of the insects are helpful also. So here, now we will see what are the plant diseases which are caused due to the microorganisms. So most of the microorganisms are also harmful to the plant. What are the microorganisms here? Bacteria, fungus, and the virus. And all these are causing diseases in the human beings, isn't it? This also you are familiar, which you have come across in your 8th standard, isn't it? So how these are harmful to the plants, also you have learned. Once again, I'll recapitulate it for you. Bacteria, it causes canker disease, crown gall, and blight disease in plants, whereas fungus causes smut disease, mold disease, and the rust disease. And the virus causes mosaic virus disease, spotted wilt disease, and curly top. So all these are the, I have taken few as the examples, but many more diseases are there which are caused by these microorganisms. So how can we control these diseases? So here I have given few steps, methods by which we can control the microbial diseases in plants are pruning and burning of affected parts. Pruning in the sense we have to remove, or we have to detach. If the one leaf is affected, then we have to detach that leaf from the stem, and we have to burn that leaf, or we have to put that leaf, mostly we have to burn that leaf. Next, we have to spray chemicals. What type of chemicals? Bactericides and fungicides must be sprayed. What is the meaning of side? C-I-D-E means to kill. Okay, what it kills means bacteria. Bactericide means the substance which kills the bacteria. Fungicide, C-I-D-E, side means to kill, which kills the fungus. So we have to use the chemicals which can kill the bacteria and the fungus. And we have to use genetically resistant strains. genetically resistant strains means we have to use such type of plants, such type of seeds, which are resistant to the diseases, which cannot be attacked, which can resist the attack of bacteria and virus. Okay, so which can increase, which has more immunity power. Such type of seeds we have to select. So such type of seeds with more immunity power is called as a genetically resistant strains. Strains is variety. So such type of variety we have to use. So I hope you have understood what are the plant diseases caused because of the various microorganisms and what are the controlling methods of those diseases. Now we will see what are the symptoms can we see in the plants if the microorganisms attack. So most of the microorganisms are harmful to the plant. Can we see the microorganisms on the plants? Means we cannot see. Then how can we know that it is a microbial attack? Means by observing the symptoms on the plant, by observing the changes which is exhibited by the plant. So what symptoms or what changes can we find in the plant? Means we can find a shriveling and discoloration of leaves. Here the leaves have changed its color. So this is called as discoloration. The leaves will change its color and also the leaves get shriveled. Shriveled means becoming wrinkled and contracted is called as shriveling. If the leaves shrivel or becomes decolorized, then it is a symptom that the microorganisms have been attacked. And rusting of stem and leaves. Rusting in the sense it is characterized by the changing of its color to brown color, isn't it? The color is brown. So if the leaves and the plants changes its color into brown, these type of brown spots are found, then that symptom is called as a rusting of either if it is on stem, then it is called as a rusting of stem. And if it is on the leaves, it is called as a rusting of leaves. This is also a characteristic symptom which shows that microorganisms have been attacked. And there will be the fungal growth. The fungal growth is seen on the plants. So all these are the symptoms which exhibits or which confirms that the plant is affected by the harmful microorganisms. Okay, now here, you concentrate here. The diseases caused by insects and microorganisms affect crop production, isn't it? And then how should we deal this problem? So how can we deal this problem? So these are the methods to control harmful insects. So how can we control the insects means, harmful insects means by chemicals. By spraying the chemicals or by weeding and by predators and by capturing. So here by chemicals, we can use the chemicals called as herbicides. Those are called as insecticides, pesticides. By using these chemicals, we can kill the insects. And by weeding, in previous slide I have said you that weeds mostly becomes the host for some of the insects. So insects accommodate on the weeds and can attack our crop plants, isn't it? So by weeding, we have to remove the weeds which can help in the controlling of the harmful insect population. So how can we remove the weeds? Again, it is by the manually or mechanically we can remove. We can use the chemicals which are called as herbicides and by using of biological methods. And by predators means predator means the organism which eats the other organism. For example, if you take the lion and the deer, lion eats the deer. So the lion is called as a predator, whereas deer is called as the prey. So we're using the predators means the animals which eat the insects, such type of animals we have to use. So what those predators are means some of the birds will eat the insects. So we have to grow such birds in our field and we can use some other insects which depend upon the insects which are harmful to our field. and also by capturing the insects. So by capturing the insects, how can we do this? Means by lighting the lamps. In the evening hours, when you light the lamps, what happens? All the insects will come to the closer to the lighter. Then we can capture them and we can kill those, so that our field can be safeguarded. And and also we can use some of the hormones called as pheromones, which attracts all the male insects. When the male insects come, then also we can capture those male insects and we can kill those. Then the females cannot undergo reproduction, so that the insect population can be controlled. So by using the pheromones, those hormones which are secreted by the some of the insects, we can use those pheromones also in our fields, so that the insects, all the male insects, can come to that pheromone thinking that the female insect is there. Then we can capture those and we can kill those. Then the female insects cannot undergo reproduction and insect population can be controlled. So these are the various ways by which we can control the harmful insects. Next, here one more question is given. Do you think all the above methods are safe to use? Here I have given four different methods. One is by using of chemicals, second is by weeding and by predators, and by capturing of the insects. Do you think all these four methods are safe to use or safe to all the environment means? No, this is the most dangerous or harmful one, by using of chemicals. If we go on using the chemicals, it is very dangerous. In what way it is dangerous, we will see in the further slide. Okay. So here, what are the side effects of using chemicals to control insects? If we use the chemicals like insecticides, pesticides, bactericides or fungicides, then our food becomes chemicalized. Most of these chemicals, when we spray, will be absorbed by the soil, will be absorbed by the plant and are stored in different parts of the plant. So when we take those plant parts, then those chemicals enters into our body. So what effect it will show, I will tell you further, but our food becomes chemicalized. So due to that, what happens means our immunity power decreases. We will become more susceptible to the diseases. We will get so many diseases. We will not have resistant power towards the diseases. And we don't have enough energy. Okay. When we use the chemicalized food, we don't have enough energy. And we will get early old age. That means we won't be young for longer time. We will become old. Though our age is less, we will exhibit the symptoms as we are old. And next to what happens if we use the chemicals means there will be increase in the immunity of the insects. See here, children, first we will, for example, if we use a little amount of the chemicals to control the insects, then the insects will die. Slowly what happens, the insects will get habituated to that amount of the chemicals and it will not get affected by small quantity of the chemicals. Then what happens, we have to increase the dose of the chemicals. Then again, the insects will die. Okay, again, after a few days, again, it will get resistance power. Again, it will get increase its immunity to resist that chemicals. Again, we have to increase the dose of the chemical. If we go on increasing the dose of the chemical, is that good for our health? Is that good for our environment? Means it is not at all good. It becomes, the soil becomes polluted, the air and water also gets polluted, and finally the food will also get polluted. So by using of chemicals leads to the increase in the immunity of insects. Okay, so we should not use the chemicals. What is the side effect of using chemicals means destruction of useful insects and microorganisms. See here, children, in previous slide, I have said you that all the insects are not harmful to human beings, but some of the insects are useful also. For instance, I have given the example of honeybees. So when we are spraying the pesticides on our crop, then other useful insects will also get affected. When useful insects get affected, then the crop production decreases because there will be no pollination. So no pollination is one of the result of destruction of useful insects and useful microorganisms. And the second is soil loses its fertility. Soil loses its fertility. These two are the outcomes. These two are the results of destruction of useful insects and microorganisms. Okay. Next, now we will see, till now we have seen the harmful effects of chemicals, isn't it? But now in this slide we will see what are the effects of chemicals on human health. How those are, when in the previous slide I said you that food becomes chemicalized. So when we consume such type of food, what happens to us? Or when the farmers spray such type of chemicals in the fields, those chemicals will be inhaled by the farmers. So when the chemicals are inhaled or consumed, then what are the health, what are the diseases the human beings will get? We will see now. The first is cardiovascular problems they will get. Cardio means heart, vascular means blood vessels. They will get heart and blood vessel related problems. They will get heart attack, and they will also get respiratory problems. Okay, and reproductive problems are seen in the males. When human beings consume this type of chemicalized food, or when they inhale the chemicals, then mostly in males, reproductive problems arises. Nerve disorders are also seen, and tumors or cancer is also seen in most of the human beings. Okay, so these are the problems. In addition to these, there are further more problems, but I have taken few as example. So it is very dangerous to inhale or consume chemicalized chemicals. Now, it is the final thing, that is evaluation. So you have to write the question answers, what I am reading out the questions, and you should get evaluated from your teachers. So what are weeds? Name some weeds found in your area. I said weeds are the unwanted plants, okay, which are growing in our crop. Those unwanted plants are called as weeds. So the weeds are grass, okay, dandelion, I have shown you, is it, and many other. And the second is write about various effects of weeds on our crop. So what are the effects of weeds on our crop? Means our crop production decreases because the weeds compete with our crop for the nutrients, for the space, for water, and also it will take maximum sunlight by growing in a fast range when compared to our crop. And also it accommodates, it gives a shelter to the pathogens, which causes diseases to our crop. So these are the effects. How can we control weeds growth? Means we can remove the weeds with our hands, which is manually, or by using any other tools which comes under the mechanical method, by using of herbicides which comes under the chemical method, that is 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid is the chemical which is used to control the dicot weeds. And also we can use some of the biological methods also. Next, give reason. Insects can lead to the decrease in the crop production. Insects can lead to the decrease in the crop production. What is the reason? How they can decrease? Means most of the insects will eat the stems. Some will destroy the roots, and few will eat the leaves. When the leaves are eaten, then what happens? The amount of chlorophyll decreases, which leads to the decrease in the photosynthesis, which leads to a decrease in the production of food. So like this, the productivity decreases. And when the stems are eaten, then also there will be no proper transportation of oxygen, carbon dioxide, and also the water, which also leads to the low growth of the plant. If the roots are destroyed, then also there will be no absorption of the water by the roots, and the plant will dry. These all will lead to the decrease in the crop production. Next, insects are both useful and harmful to plants. Give reason. Yes, insects are both harmful and useful. Insects are harmful because it can destroy the stems, leaves, and the roots of the crop plants, which leads to the decrease in the production of the crop. This is the first thing. But how those are useful means because of the insects only, pollination is brought out. Most of the pollination is brought out because of the insects. If the pollination is done, then only the food is prepared. So insects are both useful and harmful. Next, right few bacterial, fungal, and viral diseases seen in the plants. You can give many examples. For bacterial diseases, you can give canker as an example. This is a fungal smut rust disease and the viral mosaic disease. Okay. And the last question is, what are the health disorders seen in man due to pesticides? So what are the health disorders means cardiovascular problems will be seen in the plant, in the human beings, and respiratory problems also arise, nerve related issues, and also reproductive problems occur in the males, and cancer is also seen in the human beings if the humans inhale or consume chemicals. Okay, I hope you have understood the complete topic. Go through the content given in your textbook and try to answer all these questions on your own and get it evaluated from your teachers. Thank you for watching my class. Meet you soon in the next class with a new topic.